Our initial charge was to really look at how the city of Amarillo needed to fund growth for infrastructure as we move forward in the future. We established our why, and that ended up becoming our mission statement. The mission of our committee was creating a comprehensive city roadmap to grow, sustain, and develop opportunity for Amarillo. There was a consultant named Kim Lee Horn that came, and along with the city engineering staff, the planning staff, and they provided us with really the state of the city where we are today, and then helped us understand the challenges that we had based on the last master plan for each area of infrastructure. So we looked at four primary infrastructure: streets, drainage, water, and sewage, and where we had adequate funding and where we had shortfalls. Three of the areas have what's called an enterprise fund. And an enterprise fund is something that you pay on a utility bill. So water, sewer, and drainage, all three have a enterprise fund. The funds raised through those fees can only be spent on that specific area. The bulk of the committee really felt good about that because it is a promise to deliver a service. Right now, it's hard to have an expectation when there's not enough funding for that core infrastructure based on what we learned. Our water is very close to being fully funded. Still has a little bit of a shortfall. The same with sewer. And when you look at the total dollars on water and sewer, it's not a huge amount of money over the next 5 years that we have a shortfall. When you get to drainage, the number gets much bigger. And with streets, it's based on our last master plan, which was 2016, was about $380 million shortfall over the next 5 years. So streets far and away is where we have our greatest revenue shortfall. And streets is the only utility that doesn't have an enterprise fund. And so what we're seeing is our cities having to fund things as they break because they're urgent and important, instead of having the ability to plan it out over time. The committee first recommended creating a street fund. And the second thing is that we recommended raising the rates on each one of those funds to the level to fully support the continued maintenance, repair, and replacement that we have on our current system, and also to plan for growth. And then the second part of that is, once they're fully funded, we recommended that the council look at reducing the property tax rate when that burden's been taken off of it through creating these funds. I just fell in love with our community. It's the people, number one. And then being able to see what we can do when we all work together. The ballpark is an amazing success. I know that we can do that throughout the community. We got to take care of each other, and that's why I'm passionate about it.